Everyone, James from TDB here, bringing you another in-betweenisode. Today, the big blue pot of ripe is out. Gonna be drinking some ripe. So this one is from Eon Tea. It is the Jingu Brick. I split one of these with Garrett, just upside down. Almost through with drinking this tea. So wanted to feature it, as I do most ripes that I drink all the way through on the show. And let you know my thoughts on it now that I finished it. 125 grams if you're drinking it daily. Goes awfully quick. So it's been a couple of weeks basically being a regular in the blue boot pot. And now I'm almost through with it. So and I think this one is from Eon Tea 2008, of course. It's got that classic Eon storage. And I think it's a little bit different for those of you that have kind of tried and gotten seasoned on stuff like the Best Taste, which I keep an arm's reach away, and the Purple Mark, which is kind of a weird half-ripe, half-raw one, which are really heavy on that ginseng, earthiness, very classical Hong Kong taste. I think this one's a little different in a nice way, in a good way, in a way that I would totally recommend. I feel like I tend to go for these sorts of cheap and cheerful and very drinkable ripe pours from Eon. I am a sucker for them, and I think this one totally fits the bill as being worth the money. It's only 150 Hong Kong dollars, so one I can wholeheartedly recommend, something that you're getting with age, but it's also a little different from kind of your other examples of Hong Kong traditional. They describe this as being kind of a nice intro ripe, and I think I mostly agree. This one, as delicate as these things can get, I think this is on the more delicate end. It's not as heavily earthy as those teas. But anyways, I should probably drink this before I totally go overboard as far as explaining it. Cheers. Yeah, it has a really nice sweetness. I'd say it's definitely on the sweeter end of ripe teas. Not that it's like tastes like sugar cane or anything like that, but it has that, pairs that kind of like natural earthiness to it with kind of like these kind of more fragrant upper notes to it. So it feels like, I don't know, it feels like a real palate enhancing tea rather than being just totally low and bassy, if that makes sense. As I said, it's not heavily earthy and as ginseng as some of the other Eon teas. And in that sense, it's nice. Not quite as robust, perhaps, but nice. I also have found that this is a tea that I enjoy personally when it's pushed a little harder. The last tea I filmed with earlier today, actually, is a Sha Guan. And it's like those teas, you really need to tread very carefully as far as brewing and stuff. Very, very much easy to overdo. I think this is kind of the opposite. You are more at risk of underdoing a tea like this. And it's a tea that's very, very flexible and forgiving as far as just brewing. So it's the sort of tea that you could forget about in the pot. And it'd probably still come off tasty, perhaps even tastier, because the body and the experience of it is just going to be enhanced quite a bit. So I'm probably on steep number 6 during the day, just been slowly sipping at this. It's not the most enduring ripe, but it is quite good for what it is. I mean, 150 Hong Kong dollars, I think that's about, I don't know, that'd be like $25, so 10 cents a gram. So we're really looking at some very, very inexpensive daily drinker sorts of tea. And I think this tea totally fits that. I don't want to blabber too long on camera. As you can see, there's a little bit of brew left over, so I'm totally willing to stack a couple infusions here. And for whatever reason, and perhaps it is just the power of association of coming in a brick, but this kind of reminds me a little bit of 7581 in a way. I think that's also a tea that tends to not be as heavily earthy and has a little bit more of a fragrant upper level taste. Some people call that like kind of like Chinese red dates in that tea. And this tea does remind me a little bit of that. That's not a regular brew for me, mainly because I have not been able to find an expensive good one that I like, but it reminds me kind of a cross of that tea with kind of a slightly different sweetness to it. I have not had a ton of ripe pour out of Jingu. This one even says it's organic on the wrapper. I don't know if you trust those things 100%, but if you are an organic chaser, I'm not, then it says so on the wrapper. So, I don't know. Maybe they should sell it at your local co-op. Cheers. Just a really, really pleasant daily drinker. This next brew, Even Pushed, pretty similar to the last brew, and that's been my experience with this tea. Assuming you can brew it pretty consistently, you're going to get a pretty solid amount of brews, a little less longevity than perhaps the Best Taste or Purple, but maybe just a steep or two less, and for the most part, pretty solid. So I'll probably do one less steep of this after lunch in the afternoon, just get a little afternoon caffeine in. It's the sort of price where you can just brew this for a while and you don't need to necessarily go all the way with it and brew it all the way to the end. Or you can, and the tea should be totally fine that way too. So let me know if you've tried this tea. Let me know what Yeon teas you like. It's always interesting to hear what people think of Yeon. As far as I gather, there's quite a range of taste as far as preferences go for Yeon. Some people have gravitated more towards the expensive stuff like the 2000 Shaoguan Tool. I think a lot of it just depends the context that you drink this stuff. For me, this sorts of like really earthy, smooth teas, I found they're ideal daily drinkers for me and not perhaps not quite as serious. So I tend to gravitate towards the underpriced spectrum, which tends to be kind of the place where I like to just kind of try a bunch of teas and stuff like that. And if it's not the tea for you, it's only $25. So who cares? It's not the end of the world. So thank you all for tuning in, and I will see y'all next time.